In this Raspberry Pi Pico Smart Car lesson, we are going to learn how to control each individual motor in different direction. We are going to learn how to control the car so we can go forward, backwards, turn right, turn left, or maybe rotate on the axis. I'm going to explain the code fully. Welcome to Raspberry Pi Pico Smart Car course by RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri, and I will be your instructor for this course. This course is based on Sun Founder's Raspberry Pi Pico four-wheel drive car kit. Beside this 10-lesson course, the kit has full documentations, step-by-step instructions, wiring diagrams, Python codes, and example projects available for download. The car can be controlled using mobile app for mobile or tablet, where you can control the car fully forward, backward, turn right, turn left, and also you can turn on and off the light, you can set the power of the motors, you can see the speed in meter per second. You can see the radar obstacle avoidance data, where the obstacle is. Also, you can see the line tracking or a halo deep sensor data. It can track a line or follow the line. It has cliff detector, and it can follow your hand, and it can avoid obstacle and drive. The kit is available for purchase on Sun Founder and major online stores. The link to purchase the kit is below this video. Now we are going to test the motors one by one by connecting it to the board. And this is the battery. I'm connecting it to the board like this. And if I turn it on, you will see there is power. I will turn it off for now. And we're going to connect the four motors to the board. Doesn't matter which order, we just want to make sure that all the motors run and work. I'm connecting one motor, and here on this area, I'm going to connect each motor to a connector. The order doesn't matter. There is no metal, so I can leave it, no problem. Motors will run. For us to see and understand if the motor is running, I'm going to put some paper tape here on each, so you can see that. Now let me connect it to computer. And now the program is loaded, but let me turn it on. Now this is on. And from the bottom, just select the one that shows with a COM port, Raspberry Pi Pico. It has been connected. Go to View, Files. and I'm going to download to Pico 4W car main tests. And the first test that we are going to run is this one. It says test motor.py. Double click, it will open. And the test run, and so I'm gonna click again now. So the motors worked, and these are the things that the code did: forward, backward, left, right, and oh, let me zoom in. So the code did all these things: forward, backwards, left, right, and stop. So that's the code, and we are importing it as car. So any code that is there will be referred to inside the code as car. And then we are importing time. This is a function called test motor, a method called test motor. We are defining it from there up to here. It will set the speed to 50. This is a list of action that it does: forward, back, left, right. So these are the text for us. Act in the list. So each item here will be represented as act in this list. And then first we print the name. This name is being printed from this text. And after that we say car.move. Remember, car was here an object from the library that we imported. It says car.move. Move is a method inside this pico.move four-wheel drive thing that we call. It comes here, so it needs two parameters: direction and amount of power. So this one, this function is run with test motor. So when it comes here, this array runs and runs all these texts, and after that finally this will print the text on the screen: car.move with a word stop. When it's not forward, backward, left, it's automatically else mean stop. So 000 when it receives the stop. The stop, and also this sets the lights off if they are on. And here, if you want to test the motor continuously, at the bottom of the code, just after this for loop and then time sleep, write while true and with a colon. So this means forever, and then test motor. And it was like this: try test motor, light off. So I just changed it to this. And when you run this code, the motor will run continuously forever. Let me turn it on and let's power it up. So it goes forward, backward. And here also I want to show you the encoder. Here is how the encoder works. Now we know that the motors are working and there is no problem with it. And let's power it up. So it goes forward, backward. And here also I want to show you the encoder. Here is how the encoder works. Between these two pieces, the signal goes from one to the other one, and this encoder, and every time it crosses, so we have this, let me remove it. So you can see we have these holes and we have fixed number of holes. Let me count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So we have 20 holes, and this photo interrupter emits signal one and the other one receives it. And when this goes and it cuts, and when this goes and it cuts it 20 times, it means one revolution have been completed, because this will cut it 20 times. And we will count it, and also the counting will help to know the speed. In this case, we are just counting the speed, and so you can see it. I just put my phone as a source of light. Now let's have a look at the code for speed encoder. Under the test, click test speed. We have a defined a method called test speed, which ends in here, and then we have this try, which runs the test speed. When this code runs here, comes, we have defined a new method called helper. This will not run until you call it. So from here to here, it's just a method that receives an argument called power and gets the power divided by 10, and then makes a random number and multiply it by 10, so that is the power. And then we use this car object.move method, and we send the command power with the amount of power that we calculated this from this line. So this moves the car, and this is just printing it with the word power, and it gets this value of power. Prints it, and then it also formats the speed with two decimal places, car and car speed. So this method will give you the car speed at any moment that you need. And then we wait for 200 milliseconds. So this method will not run until this loop runs it. So this loop says while true, which means forever. It runs these three for loop. First loop goes from, so this loop runs from 0 to 100, and every time the value of power changes from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 100, and it comes here, and we call the helper, which I've just explained. So this will run, move the car, and print the text for 200 milliseconds, and that's done. Then it comes back and it becomes 0, 1, 2, 3. Once it reaches 100, then we go here from 100 back to minus 100. The power changes an increment of minus 1. So it decrements it. Minus 100 means go in the opposite direction. When the value is negative, it goes to the negative direction. And after that, it starts from minus 100 to 0. Up to minus 100. So up to full speed in the other direction. When that ends, we go from 100 from the other direction, we will slow it down until we reach 0. Every time we'll run with a helper. And the speed is also displayed here. That's centimeter per second. And stop. Then it goes backwards, power minus 20, that means in the opposite direction. So we have inside this. Now, thank you for watching a Raspberry Pi Pico lesson from RoboJax. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and thumb up the video. You can wait a few seconds. The next lesson will start automatically, or click on the link to proceed now.